guys, welcome to my new YouTube channel. I hope you guys enjoy this channel. This is not gonna be this kind of thing, but just for the sake of Halloween, we wanted to make a scary video. Now this may happen in every Halloween because honestly we're Halloween fanatics, but it's beside the point. But I hope you guys enjoy this video. As I said, it's gonna be a scary video, so if you're sensitive to those kind of things, I wouldn't recommend watching this because it's pretty scary, let's be honest. So before we start, I'm gonna let him introduce himself.
Hello, my name is Omar Martinez and I am her boyfriend. I have my own YouTube channel that I'm just starting up. It's called How to Gorilla and it's gonna be linked down below. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so I'm gonna get started first with these scary stories. So the first one happened probably when I was around 5-6 years old. It was one of the first places that I lived in. So what happened was I was sitting down in the couch with my big sister and my mom. I was 5 because my little brother hadn't been born yet and he's 6 years younger than me. Anywho, carrying on. So we were sitting down there. My dad wasn't home because he was working late. I didn't like sleeping alone or going to my room alone. So meaning that I was just sitting with my mom and sister while my mom helped her with her homework. And you know, I was bored. So I was just sitting down looking around, like every 5-year-old does. And I just started staring at the hallway that led to the bathroom, our room, and my parents' room. So it was a bathroom, room, and then our room. So I was just looking over there, just, distracting myself. And as I looked over there, I saw a shadow walking past the bathroom to my parents' bedroom. And you know, you might say, oh, it was just your peripheral vision, or you know, you just saw a thing, you thought you saw something. But the thing was, I was looking straight at it. I saw it pass from side to side clearly. And this was just a black figure. I didn't see any kind of features. It just walked past and that's the end of it. I didn't see it again. I didn't feel anything again. That was it. So I really don't know what that was, but that really spooked me out. So thank you for giving me more reason to not want to go sleep in my room. Second story, which happened in this house, freaked me out a lot more than that experience, surprisingly, since I was a 5-year-old back then, and when this happened, I was, 19? Which was like a year ago, and it happened in this very house. So what happened was, we had just gotten home from grocery shopping, and I was helping my mom bring down the groceries. Everyone was outside, including Ines. My sister had just come in with groceries, and I came in next. So she came in. As I was coming in through the door, I was carrying groceries and I saw something. So our hallway isn't that wide. So it was from the beginning of the hallway going to the kitchen door. So basically maybe 4 feet that I saw. But I saw a woman with a long dress and long blonde hair walking from the beginning to the inside of the kitchen, and for some reason, which I still don't get to this day, in my head it registered, this is your sister. My body, my mind thought, this is your sister. Though my sister looks nothing like that. My sister has black hair, And she never wears those kinds of dresses. It looked like a long white dress, the kind that you would see like in a movie or something. And she just walked by. So I was like, oh, it's my sister. Let me go say hi, or let me just, you know, go see her. So I walked with my groceries. I left them inside the kitchen, and I didn't see my sister in the kitchen. But there's a door inside the kitchen that leads to the garage. I thought maybe she went to the garage for something, you know? People often go to the garage. So I open the door of the garage and I walk in, take a couple of steps. And as I start taking the steps, I realize there's no one in here. And that's when I freak out. So I did what any logical person would do. I just slowly walked back and got out the house. You guys don't know how many lives I would save in movies. Movies aren't logical. Later on, I found out that my sister had dropped off the groceries and gone to the bedroom, because I saw her in the bedroom, in my parents' bedroom, which is all the way at the end of the hallway. And it's not like I wouldn't have seen her walk, because the distance from the door to the kitchen is like, what, 12 feet? And it's impossible to miss, trust me. That's my scary stories.
My turn. So, most of my paranormal stories, goodness, couldn't speak, happened when I was really, really young. Don't get me wrong, I have a lot that happened later on, but. Now, how I remember these stories still, I have no idea, but I do. So, let's tell them. So, the very first story has a continuation to it. So, if you guys would like to know the rest of it, just like or comment down below and let me know that you would absolutely love to know the rest. And I would for sure make the other videos. So, the very first story happened when I was 4. Just like the second story, it happened when I was 4 too, but whatever. So my mom had this routine with me where she would bathe me and then she would comb my hair, clean my ears, do all that jazz. So she had just bathed me and I was in her bedroom because that's where she would put me to comb my hair and all that. And when you walk into my parents' bedroom, the bed, like you walk in and then the bed is on the right side. And then if you look further to the right, there was a window, a really big window that led to the deck. And in that deck, it was a really long deck. It was as long as the house. But where my parents' bedroom started, the deck ended. The continuation of that deck was just a wall. And then there was a separation. And then there was another deck. And in that deck, there was a wall as well, which separated the two.
And on and on.
Yeah, the whole exactly. Complex. And just so you know, we lived in the second floor, so that's important for the story. So, I was sitting in my parents' bedroom, and if you looked in front, there was a TV. So I was watching TV, and then I got bored, I'm guessing. I don't really remember, I was 4. And then I was looking at the window and nothing was out of the ordinary, you know, just looking at nothing, basically. And it was really, really dark outside because it was like 8 p.m., I want to say, and it was winter. So, as you can imagine, it was dark. And my mom was cleaning my ears. Gross, I know. But I was just looking and I saw this black figure with no features run across the deck, and I mean run, like for real run. And this figure, the only thing that you could really tell about it was it had a hat, a very distinct hat, and it had red glowing eyes that freaked me out real bad. especially when you're four. And as cartoony as this may sound, but it had a cape. So as it was running, it looked at me straight up, and it was like making eye contact with me the whole time until it like disappeared. And then I saw the cape flowing as it was running, basically speaking. That was extremely scary, but there's more to it, so stay tuned for that if you want to know. Now the second story is even scarier. So I'll explain to you the house that I used to live in, so you know it was my grandparents' house. That doesn't really matter, but yeah. So let's say you walked in the house, and on the right side there was the kitchen, and then on the left side there was a living room / dining room, and then if you looked in front it was a long hallway, and you walked and the very first room on the left would be my grandparents, and then you walked a little bit more and then there was a little, I want to say like a walk-in closet most kind of, or laundry room, I don't really remember. And then you walked up and then you'd walk a little more and then it would be the bathroom. On the left side it would be my room and my brother's, because we slept in the same room in bunk beds. And then in very front would be my parents' bedroom. Now in that room that I slept with my brother, I was very scared of the closet, because every night I would see a man in that closet. I don't know why, but I would, and I was terrified of it. So basically every night I would sleep with my grandparents. So as every night would go, I woke up in the middle of the night, didn't like what I was feeling, so I walked down from my bunk bed, and underneath I saw my brother sleeping, like I always did, and he was in his pajamas, and this is very important, so pay attention to this. He was asleep in his bed in pajamas. Okay. Black. So I walked into my grandparents' bedroom, and I woke up my grandma, and I was like, "Grandma, can I sleep with you?" Blah, blah, blah. And she said, "Yes." No. I got in the middle of them two. Them two meaning my grandparents, my grandpa and my grandma. And we always had this thing of sleeping with doors open. But I was looking into the hallway. It was very dark, of course. We never left the lights on or anything. And I was looking, as I was looking into the hallway, I saw my brother. And my brother had, like, workout clothes. I had seen him wear this before, so it wasn't unusual for me to see that those clothes on him. But I had just seen him in pajamas. And not only did he have workout clothes on, but he had, like a bag, like a traveling bag, kind of, from, like, Adidas or something. I'm not 100% sure, but he was just standing in the middle of the doorway of my grandparents' bedroom. And he was straight up looking into my eyes, and I was looking straight at him. And he had this very evil smile. Like, it didn't even look like a smile that my brother could have, because it was so evil. It was just so strange. I don't know if it was a smile or if it was the feeling that it gave me as he was smiling, but it was terrifying. And I don't know how this happened, but he was just gone all of a sudden. I don't know if I closed my eyes or if I just turned around and then looked back. I don't know, but I just know that he wasn't there anymore. And mind you that I was like 4 or 5, or maybe even younger. So that makes my brother, what, like 10, 11? So, as a brave little girl that I was apparently, I got up and I went to go check if my brother was in the room, because if he wasn't, I would have to tell my parents, because, you know, dangerous for kids to be out at that age and that late in the night. So I walk in my room and my brother is asleep with his pajamas on, and he's very, very asleep. Very asleep meaning I tried to wake him up and he didn't wake up. So yeah, that was that. So I hope that we didn't scare you too much. And I hope you have an amazing Halloween. If you have any suggestions that you want me to make, mind you that this is going to be kind of like a comedy channel, leave them down below. Also, we're going to do a bunch of challenges because I really like challenges.
Cool.
And tags and all that stuff. So,
any comments, any questions, any ideas?
Anything. We would appreciate if you left them down below.
Yeah.
So, don't forget to check out his channel. We'll leave all our social medias down below. Goodness, I can't speak. And I hope you have an amazing Halloween.
Yeah.